Righto. So since the previous part I was speaking about how people malign themselves with the belief of as much as I can get here on earth, I'm going to run with it. They malign themselves with acquiring lots and lots here on earth without considering eternity. And so they just act a fool. In the last days, it is written in God's word that people are going to be lovers of themselves and lovers of money. Of course, there is the rest of that passage. You can go and peruse it. Okay. The reason why people love money so much in the last days is because in the last days, when the Lord returns, it is written of him that will he find faith on the earth. There will be no eternal perspective, and even if it's there, it's going to be a very fluffy one that has no judgment. And so when then you don't have an eternal perspective that is holy and righteous, that will throw you into whatever might be the ecosystem that you worshipped when you were here on earth. If you were godly, you will be with Christ forever. If you were not, you will then be in the eternal lake of fire. Upon then not holding on to that, you try to fulfill as best of a life as you possibly can here. Whatever years you might have on earth, you try to be as successful materially here on earth as you possibly can. You want to be the youngest entrepreneur in your family. You want to be the youngest person within your niche, your ecosystem. You want to be an innovator. You want to be wealthy or retire by the age of 35. You want all of these stats that make mankind feel like they have arrived. Do you understand? And in the acquisition or in the pursuit of that alleged happiness, you will trample on whatever you need to trample. So if you don't have natural gifting, or if you are kind of restricted by resources in your environment, or people are not quite giving you the respect you want and you desire, you will then go and steal it. So people who dabble with witchcraft, then the first time they get that job using sorcery, God have mercy on Garabo, my goodness, wow. The people who consult for the first time, once they gain the power, or they taste the powers of this dark kingdom that give them things for free that they have not earned, they get addicted. And since they are working for nothing but this earth that is finite, but to them they think it's the be all and end all to like chase after, they then are like, what else can I get with this veil on of anonymity? What else, since the superego has been removed out of the way, what else can I gain? What else can I gain? And so they look around and they're like, I want a house, I want a new car, I want the promotion, I want to get promoted within 6 months after working this job, I want this and I want that. And so they just keep on stealing and stealing. And the thing about constantly going back to the drawing board to visit Asangoma to achieve certain things is that there is no end then to what you will go and ask this spiritist for. So now you meet a woman in the office that you find attractive and you try and pursue her. She doesn't want you. And then you're like, ha, I once got a job. Yeah, without going to God, and I got a much better job than the one that I would have earned based on my skills and qualifications. So I can go and get myself the best woman in the world using witchcraft. If I tell you guys, I'm not saying that I am the baddest chick in the game, but according to some guys, I'm a pretty excellent find or whatever. If I tell you how many guys in my company alone, my organization, never mind at school, never mind at play, never mind wherever ecosystem church that I used to go to, just at work, how many guys, yo, batong, hey batong, put witchcraft on me, like witchcraft to marry them. I don't know how many times I've woken up in a cold sweat in the morning after being forcibly married to a guy I was wholeheartedly unattracted to in waking life. And I'd be like, Avosi, I don't like him. Jomo, I don't like him. Tepo, I don't like him. Of course, those names are false, okay? Those names are not their real names type thing. But I have had dudes ask me out using witchcraft. And I'd be like, whatever happened to basic chivalry and old school manhood where you walk up to a girl all sweaty palmed and you're like, hey, would you like to have a drink? Would you like to go and grab some coffee? Whatever happened to good old fashioned courtship? No. They first consult the Sangoma. Why? Because they thoroughly understand a woman is out of his league. Similarly too with women, they thoroughly understand that a man is out of their league. And so since you are in no position to be with Utapelo or with Utepiso or with Ujomo Uvo, since you think Vose is up there and you're down here, you then go to a Sangoma as a female and you're like, here is this guy, took his photo off Facebook, make him feel attracted to me and pursue me. They get men pursuing them using witchcraft, and the men get women desirous of them using witchcraft. And so therefore, by the time they go in for the kill, the girl has already been made mud. She's already putty in his hands, dough. And the woman, when then then you see her coming together with the man, the whole environment and the ecosystem can tell Uguti, this doesn't make sense. How did Karabo end up with this guy? How did Maina end up with that guy? How did Renelo Kifilwe Zaza? How did they end up, these chicks, with Umdonjena? That's why you are finding in the 21st century some of the most beautiful, gorgeous, and we're thinking everything is in, like, you know, a bunch, like bullet checklist point, as in she's beauty, brains, godliness, this, that, ending up with some dude with a rap sheet that will, like, make some people in prison shy. It'll make some people who are serving time for murder literally scrimmage into a corner on some, I couldn't get that bad. And Zaza is married to him. It is happening all over the black community, and you just look at it in the entertainment industry. Just go with the entertainment industry. Only look at some of the women, the men, sorry, that some of these really prolific stars in the entertainment industry are married to. Just look at it. Beyonce and Jay-Z is like, I feel like the most primary one that you can actually look at. But in South Africa, Ambanyo Balanda, Bonke, Labafazi, and Wanda, Grandchap, what's happening? How some women are also even falling pregnant by guys that don't make sense, etc. But this is not that discussion, that argument. They go and they fetch sorcery for anything and everything. For a wife, or Funuk Shada, okay, I'm going to get a woman that's out of my league. Business-wise, I'm going to get a promotion I haven't earned. But what happens when you grab a woman that is not in your league and you marry her? What happens when you get a promotion that you have not worked for and you're now in that job as the CEO or the MD or the, what you call this, the leader, whatever, project team leader, supervisor, whatever it is that you might have found yourself in, or that business opportunity, thank you. Many of them within business who are entrepreneurs also win tenders this way. So you who have gotten the contract to build this particular gymnasium, now that you are in it, even though you have not the skills to actually do this thing, what happens, guys, on that day? What happens? Please tell me what happens on that day. It's called incompetence. Okay, it's not anybody lanam echatin. It's called incompetence. They become incompetent. They don't truly have the skill. They don't truly have the talent. And they don't truly have the honor to be the husband of such wife as this. And so in the case of a relationship, we're dealing now with gender-based violence, with exorbitant envy, jealousy of your spouse, your partner, resulting then in likely emotional abuse of what do you call this? Psychological, mental abuse. Resulting in verbal abuse, you are unsupportive, cheating, gaslighting, reverse psychology, things that you do to a person to make them feel like they're nothing, belittling of them. That's what happens when you get a woman that's out of your league having used ikorobela. You will eventually be insecure. And the same thing, of course, goes vice versa with men, where it is that you have now acquired and made this like guy become a little bit of his tutsela, a zombie, to marry you. And you have not, you're not in his league. You're going to get cheated on like no man's business. He is going to, witchcraft does not, it doesn't sit, it doesn't stick. Okay, it's not super glue. It sticks more like bostik, like prestik. If you put something heavy on iprestiki, ultimately over time, it's just going to fall off to the ground. So over time, sorcery wears off. That's just the thing. It wears off, you guys. It wears off. And so because it wears off, it has like a... why does witchcraft wear off, guys? Even on a person that is not saved. Oh, let's go to the next.